Hello everybody and welcome back to Let's Play Xanadu for the MSX. Now as promised in this part we will be looking at the towers of level 8. So let's push on straight away. Like I said, this is the first one we'll be doing, the Asian tower, the most eastern one. And it will be interesting because we'll take a look at some of the monsters and we'll pick up some pretty interesting items as well. And these are the first of them. The shambling monsters are not the worst monsters in the level. They're still pretty strong, so you do have to be a little bit careful. As you can see, I definitely prefer using my magic to take them out. But in this case, I will attack the last one with my regular weapon just to show you a little bit of what kind of damage they do. As you can see, between 30 and 40,000, so nothing to sneeze at. But also nothing to be completely afraid of. You might have seen just now I picked up a silver pendant and a hammer, so plus 10 intelligence and strength again, as well as a demon's ring from the shamblings, which is pretty good. I think that's worth taking a little bit of damage for. I'm just opening these doors straight away because we have to come back this way anyway. Now there's a couple more shamblings in this tower, but because they don't drop anything good, I'm just going to switch to my corrosion and take them out as quickly as I can. Just to save us a little bit of time. Since we're going to magic them away anyway. Well, this is the second item I was talking about that we really want to pick up in this dungeon, and that is a crystal ball. I'm not 100% sure if we've seen this one before. What it does is it increases your magic resistance. As you can see, it's now at 75. And now we are at 85, so plus 10 magic resistance, absolutely worth it. If that was the only loot in this tower, I would definitely still go in. Unfortunately, we came in through a one-way exit, so we have to go this way to get back outside. Here we go. Oh yeah, and we'll pick up some random junk along the way, which we can sell later. Plus 3 small shields, splint mill, clearly not going to help us very much. Some more shamblings as well. Might actually kill the last one of this group to show you that the loot isn't really worth it. It's going to be a brown potion, if I'm not mistaken. Of course, double intelligence is nice, but we already have a stack of brown potions anyway. It's not really going to help us very much. Yeah, see, another 70,000 damage if you get a brown potion in return is not worth it. Let me check my map real quick. Oh yeah, up and then left. Am I right? B, where's B? Up. And then to the left. Yeah, that's right, to the left. Some more items. Well, Black Onyx is kind of nice. I mean, it never hurts to have an extra Black Onyx, so that's also going to be slightly worthwhile. But another brown potion we do not need. The armor, as you saw just now, was just cloth armor, so also not terribly useful because, well, cloth armor is the armor you start with. So really, there's no single circumstance in the game where picking up a cloth armor is going to help us very much. It sells for about 50 gold, I think, so yeah, pretty worthless. From here, we'll keep just moving down until we get back to the entrance. Another one-way street, as you can see. But I believe if we go to the left here, that brings us back to the entrance, if I'm not mistaken. Yep, this is it. So as you can see, a pretty short, small tower. Nothing too impressive here, but worth it for the stat-ups. Second tower is pretty similar. There's a couple of good items we want to pick up there, but it's nothing too interesting or important, so if you're low on anything or you don't feel like taking out these towers, it's not really too important. So yeah, what are we gonna do? Oh yeah, we have to go this way. There we go. So this brings us up to the western tower, the American one. So, the west tower, this one, slightly tricky. There's a couple of one-way exits, a couple of teleports, but nothing too scary. As you can see, there's really only one way we can go so far. I will go to the left first in this case, or to the right, I'm sorry. I will take out this poison because I happen to know that's where we will be exiting later. If you see a poison in the middle of a wall like that, like the one I just shot, you can. It's a pretty safe bet. There's a one-way entrance leading to it because there's no reason otherwise to put it there. This is the item we were looking for, our Giant Slayer, which is a lot better than our plus two battle axe that we had just now. So yeah, again, a worthwhile addition to our armory. These camzots, I believe, don't drop anything useful? No, just a balance, so we're gonna take them out. And this is of course the second item we want to pick up in this dungeon. It is a Holy Bible, which adds another plus 10 to our wisdom. Our wisdom is now so strong that we can definitely use items very effectively. There we go. Some more camzots to take out. These guys are a little bit scary, so I am definitely going to use my magic to wipe them out. I think in the next part I might showcase some of the strengths of these monsters a little bit, but I'll do that in a separate video, just so I don't mess up my playthrough. Here we go. And the last one. Again, these guys drop balances, so really not very worthwhile. Let's see, okay, so from here we go up, another one-way exit, then we'll go to the right. If we go straight up from here, I think we get, we'll get to the, oh no, it's a dead end, never mind. So you have to go this way and then up. Be careful, because again, there's plenty of poison to trap us. Some winged boots, always useful, no such thing as too many winged boots. More camzots that give us, what was I saying, balances, so yeah, definitely just shoot them, don't waste any of your health on them. And again, for hourglasses, also definitely worthwhile, nothing to sneeze at. These hourglasses are going to become more important from this level onwards, because there are monsters that are going to eat us alive if we don't use items to beat them. And that's pretty much it. This is where this is actually the room I saw the poison bottle in earlier. That was down there that I shot. So this is going to take us back to the exit pretty quickly, I think. Oh, that's right. I forgot. This is a one-way exit. You know what? I don't think there is a normal exit to this tower. That's actually kind of interesting. There's no way to go back up, except by using a mantle, I guess. Yeah, because I'm looking at the map. I've got all the exits mapped, and unless there's one there. No, there can't be. No, I honestly don't think there's any way out of this tower other than by using a mantle. That's strange. I don't remember that at all. But oh well. So we'll just use our mantle to pass through this wall and get back to the starting room and then go straight back out. And just for a little bit of fun, I'll show you, thanks to our higher wisdom, how long this mantle is going to last. As you can see, I can climb through pretty much the entire level with it. So even though at the start of the game I was talking about wisdom not really being that important, it's true, it's not the most important thing in the world, but at the same time, being able to do this for this long, pretty nice. clearly very useful. In fact, I think I got myself stuck there. Yep. See, that's the downside of mantles. Be very careful what you're doing, because you can easily get yourself trapped in a wall. Well, guys, I think that's my cue to reset and restart. I guess I could use another item to get myself out of here, maybe a black onyx or something. Because as you can see, we don't have any mantles left, so this was actually a little bit foolish. But I'll just reset and restart at the tower we just cleared, so it's no big deal. Thanks for watching, guys, and I will see you in the next part. Just as a little bonus, I did reset the game, and as you can see, it also reset the fact that I have my mantle still active. So let me try and see if I can use this to very quickly get up to the tower. Actually, I think I already ruined it by going the long way here, instead of going straight over here. But we might still be able to make it. Ah, just barely missed it. Okay, one more time. Okay, here we are again. It's a little bit of cheating, but well. I think, yeah, this is where we need to be. There we go. And now if I go straight there, we should be able to make it. Ah, still not enough. Okay, never mind.